How do you do? I see you've met my faithful handyman. He's a little brought down because when you knocked, thought you were the candyman. Don't get strung out by the way that I look. Don't judge a book by its cover. I'm not much of a man by the light of day, but by night I'm one hell of a lover. I'm just a sweet transvestite.
What a wonderful pleasure it is to be standing here. And thank you so much for coming along and supporting us. Now, we're here for three very good reasons. The first, of course, is to help the English Stage Company celebrate 50 years of a committed journey, which is driven by discovering, encouraging, and developing new writing for the theatre. And secondly, of course, is to applaud and raise funds for Amnesty International so that we might, in our own small way, help this essential organization in its continuing mission to protect human rights and civil liberties everywhere around the world. And last but not least, to pay tribute to a little musical which started life here at the theatre upstairs 33 years ago. The show opens with a prologue which is written in song form, and the young lady that sang it on that first night here in the Royal Court 33 years ago was a young lady by the name of Patricia Quinn. And she's back here tonight to charm us once again. Would you welcome, please, Miss Patricia Quinn?
Michael Rennie was ill the day the earth stood still, but he told us where we stand. And Flash Gordon was there in silver underwear. Claude Rains was the invisible man. Then something went wrong for Fay Wray and King Kong. They got caught in a celluloid jam. Then at a deadly pace, it came from outer space. And this is how the message ran. Double feature, Dr. X will build a creature. See androids fighting, Brad and Janet, and Francis Dawes in Forbidden Planet. George Pell to his bride, I'm gonna give you some terrible thrills, like a science fiction double feature, Dr. X show. I wanna go.
That Brad Majors and Janet Weiss inhabit is the small American Midwestern town of Denton. Brad and Janet have just attended the wedding of their two friends, Betty Monroe and Ralph Halpchat. Janet has snaffled the bride's bouquet, and we all know what that means. And here to play the Denton 2, would you welcome, please, Miss Sophie Lawrence and Mr. Adrian Edmondson?
Hey, Janet. I've got something to say. I really like the skillful way you beat the other girls to the bride's bouquet. Hey, the river was deep, but I swam it. The future is ours, so let's plan it. So please don't tell me to can it. I've one thing to say, and that's damn it, Janet, I love you. The road was long, but I ran it. There's a fire in my heart and you fan it. If there's one fool for you, then I am it. I've one thing to say, and that's damn it, Janet, I love you. Here's a ring to prove that I'm no joker. Science examine. Let me give you the eye and then panic. Janet. Now I've one thing to say, and that's damn it, Janet, I love you. Damn it, Janet.
Fred, I'm mad.
Damn it, Janet, I love you.
Now, our young people were anxious to share their engagement news with their old science teacher, Dr. Everett Scott. It's also true that there were dark storm clouds on the horizon. Yes, they got a blowout. Yes, it was raining. And no, they didn't have an umbrella. Brad volunteered to go for help.
But where will we go? I mean, you're in the middle of nowhere.
Well, didn't we pass a castle back down the road a few miles? Maybe. They have a telephone I might use.
I'll come with you.
There's no point in us both getting wet.
I'll come with you. Besides, darling, the owner of the phone may be a beautiful woman, and you may never come back.
If only it were going to be that simple.
In the velvet darkness of the blackest night, burning bright.
see the flag fly. I can see the rain just the same. There has got to be something better here for you and me.
There's a light
over the Frankenstein place.
There's a light
burning in the fireplace.
There's a light, light in the darkness of every
Brad and Janet arrive at the old dark house in which Riffraff serves as a dog's body, and by ringing the bell, they effectively bring him to the door. Brad explains their situation to this Igor figure, and the lucky couple are invited in. They're introduced to two other inhabitants of this festering mausoleum, Columbia, a tap-dancing groupie, and Magenta, sister of the sinister Riffraff.
You've arrived on a rather special night. The master is having one of his affairs.
Lucky old him,
says Janet.
It seems like only yesterday since he went.
Janet bites.
Where?
To pieces. It's astounding. Time is fleeting. Madness takes its toll. But listen closely. Not for very much longer. I've got to keep control.
Yeah.
I remember doing the time warp. Drinking those moments when the blackness would hit me. And if I would be
let's do the time warp again.
Let's
Now, believe it or not, Janet is getting a little spooked out by the way things are going. She senses that something rather unhealthy is heading her way. She's right, for this is when the owner of this gothic pile decides to put in an appearance. And here, to assay the role of the sweet transvestite from Transylvania, please welcome Mr. Anthony Head.
How do you do? I see you've met my faithful handyman. He's a little brought down because when you knocked, thought you with a candyman.
Don't get strung out by the way that I look.
Don't judge a book by its cover. I'm not much of a man by the light of day, but by night I want a hell of a lover. I'm just a sweet transvestite.
Sweet transvestite.
I'm transsexual, Transylvania.
Let me show you around, or maybe play you a sound. You look like you're both pretty groovy.
Or if you'd like something visual that's
not too abysmal, we could take in an old Steve Reeves movie.
I'm glad we caught you at home. Could we use your phone? We're both in a bit of a hurry. We'll just say where we are and then get back to the car. We don't want to be in any worry.
Oh, you got caught with a flat. Well, how about that? Well, babies, don't you panic. Because by the light of the night, you'll all seem all right. I'll get you a satanic mechanic. I'm just a sweet transvestite. For the
night,
or maybe a bite. I can show you my favorite obsession.
I've been making a man with more hair than a tan.
He's good for relieving my tension.
I'm just a sweet transvestite
from transsexual Transylvania.
I'm just a sweet transvestite.
What's on the slab?
I see you, Shiva, with anticipation.
But maybe the rain is really to blame. So I remove the corpse,
but not the symptom.
Brad and Janet were not really in a position to appreciate the philosophical ramifications of Frankenfurter's musical discourse, as the servants were busy relieving them of their wet clothes. To cover any embarrassment that our hapless couple might have been feeling, they are given white laboratory coats to put on, which, in view of where they now find themselves, was quite apt, as that's where they were in Frank's laboratory. A body lies on an operating table. Wires and tubes are attached to the bandaged waist figure. Switches are switched, levers pulled. Electricity courses through cables. And the corpus delectable twitches and spasms with life. Frankenfurter has played God and given life to his new playmates. Here to play this miracle of muscular manhood, would you welcome Mr. Gary Amos?
Yeah. The sword of Damocles is hanging over my head, and I've got the feeling someone's gonna be cutting the thread. Oh, woe is me, my life is in misery, and can't you see that I'm at the start of a pretty big downer? I woke up this morning with the start as I fell out of bed. No, left of my dreaming was a sense of unbelievable dread. But no place to go, and all I know is I'm at the start of a pretty big downer. That ain't no crime. No, no, no. No, no, no.
No, yeah. Rocky Horror, you need peace of mind. I want to tell you that you're doing just fine. You're the product of another time, and feeling down, well, that's no crime.
Sword of Damocles is hanging over my head, and I've got the feeling someone's gonna be pulling the thread. Oh, woe is me, my life is in misery, and can't you see that I'm at the
Rocky Horror is born. It should be noted that while our very unorthodox doctor is engaged in divulging his Charles Atlas approach to creation, Eddie, the delivery boy and earlier victim of Frank's scientific curiosity, arrives on the scene. He's been on ice for some time, which is just as well, as he's tending to be slightly falling apart at the seams.
Whatever happened to Saturday night? When you dressed up sharp and it felt alright. It don't seem the same since cosmic light came into my life. I thought I was divine. I used to go for the ride with a cuckoo. I listened to the music on the radio. The saxophone was playing on a rock and roll show. You climbed in the back. You really had a good time. Plastic belt, I tried a baby pink lipstick, and that's when I melt. She whispered in my ear tonight, she really was mine. Get back in front and put some hair all on. Buddy Holly was playing his very own song. With your arm around your girl, you try to sing along. You felt pretty good, cause you're having such a good time. I put you there.
Bless my soul.
It's at this point in the proceedings that things start to get a little sticky. For Brad and Janet, as Frank encourages them to taste forbidden fruit, each without the other's knowledge. And as so often happens, the truth is, they rather like it. But while their wicked host is introducing Brad to the ways of the Greeks, Rocky Horror escapes. And the newly awakened Janet finds him cowering in the laboratory. She comforts him, and while doing so, discovers that her aversion to muscles has completely vanished. So much so, she feels compelled to put her thoughts into song. Here to share those thoughts is Miss Jo Farrell.
I was feeling done in. Couldn't win. I'd only ever kissed before.
You mean she only ever...
I thought there's no use getting into heavy petting. It only leads to trouble and seat wetting. Now all I want to know is how to go. I've tasted blood and I want more. Of the main attraction, you need a friendly hand, and I need action. Touch it, touch it, touch it, touch me. I wanna be daddy. Thrill me, chill me, fulfill me. Creature of the night. Touch it, touch it, touch it, touch me.
Janet takes Rocky to her room in order that she might comfort him even more. And while doing so, a whipped riffraff, the surly and servile servant, switches on a closed-circuit TV monitor and locates Rocky in the female's quarters. Frank is more than a little put out by what he sees, but Brad is devastated. And as we so often do at times such as these, he resorts to song. Please welcome Stephen Gately.
Once in your life, she don't want to call you. Speaking on the telephone. And once in your life, she don't want to know you. You look around, the one you found, she is gone. That's all the time that it takes for a heart to turn to sweeter the wine, the harder to make the break. You hear something about someone you thought you'd know. So baby, don't cry like there's no tomorrow. After the night, there's a brand new day.
Heartbreak. The yes. The very man that he and Janet set out to visit is busy breaking into Frankenfurter's Sin Palace. He is quickly spotted by Riff Raff, Frank, and Brad on the TV monitors. Brad lets slip an involuntary gasp of surprise. Settle down. Frank's mood changes from unpleasant to paranoidal because he also knows that Dr. Everett Scott, not as a high school science teacher, but as someone who works for the Bureau of Investigation of that which we call UFOs. He becomes convinced that they have been sent on ahead of Dr. Scott to check the layout for him. Scotty is captured. Janet and Rocky are rounded up, and everyone spends a little time engaged in those activities more usually associated with family Christmas gatherings. Self-reflection, vindictiveness, recrimination, and simple open hostility. At the end of this ugly turn of events, we discover that Dr. Scott has a very personal motive for turning up. For you see, Eddie, the unfortunate delivery boy, happened to be his nephew. Here to walk us through this relationship with a little help from Columbia and Frank, will you please give a big welcome to Mr. Julian Littman? Tell us about it, Doc.
From the day he was born, he was trouble. He was the thorn in his mother's side. Oh, she tried in vain.
But he never caused her nothing but pain.
He left home the day she died. From the day she was gone, all he wanted was rock and roll porn and a motorbike shooting up junk.
He was a low-down cheap little punk,
taking everyone for a ride. When Eddie said he didn't like his daddy, you knew he wasn't no good guy. But when he touched your life, note which reads,
what's it say? What's it say?
I'm out of my head. Oh, hurry or I may be dead. They mustn't carry out their evil deeds. When Eddie said he didn't like his daddy, you knew he was a no good kid. But when he threatened your life with a switchblade knife,
what a guy.
Makes you cry.
I did.
What a guy.
Makes you cry.
Oh, I did.
What a guy.
Makes you cry.
And I did.
What a guy.
Makes you cry.
And I did.
What a guy.
Makes you cry.
And I did.
Frankenfurter throws a switch on the sonic transducer, whereby he traps Janet, Brad, and Dr. Scott, and Rocky. There's something wrong with my feet, cries Janet. My wheels! I can't move my wheels, explains Dr. Scott. As if I was glued to the spot, says Brad, employing his observational skills. A sonic transducer is a type... No, please, it's getting very difficult now. A type of audio vibratory physiomolecular transport device capable of breaking down solid matter and then projecting it through space and perhaps time itself. Janet gets the idea that perhaps they are going to be taken to another planet. Frank disabuses her of this notion in song, during which one by one they are dispatched in a highly drugged state. Yes, already it's become one of those parties. When they are all trapped in a molecular state somewhere between entrance and exit. Frank instructs Columbia to see that they are prepared as a chorus line for the narcissistic fantasy floor show that he has planned for that time of the morning. When your drink in your hand is green, your eyes itch, and your mouth has become something really unacceptable to keep your tongue in. Columbia is rather tired and emotional and has far too much to say for herself, so she is sent off to join the others in the chorus.
Schmat it, Janet.
I'll tell you once,
won't tell you twice.
You better wise up, Janet Weiss. Your apple pie don't taste too nice. You better wise up, Janet Weiss. I've laid the seed, it should be all you need. You're as sensual as a pencil wound up like an Eeyore first string when we made up. Did you hear a bell ring? You got a block. Take my advice. You better wise up, Janet Weiss. The transducer will seduce you. It's something you'll get used to. A mental mind fuck can be nice. You better wise up, Janet Weiss. Build your thighs up, Janet Weiss. You better wise up.
Stop!
Don't get hot and flustered. Use a bit of mustard.
You're a hot dog, but you better not try to hurt her. Frankfurter, you're a hot dog, but you better not try to hurt her. Frankfurter, you're a hot dog.
Frankenfurter's review is a hymn to hedonism. His own shallow view of it, anyway. It's a rather wild affair and requires several singers to bring it off. At the end of Frank's whooping it up, Riff Raff turns up with his sultry sister Magenta, and he's packing a laser capable of emitting a beam of pure antimatter. He tells Frank in no uncertain terms that the party is over.
Just the same. Give yourself over to absolute pleasure. Swim the warm waters of sins of the flesh. Erotic nightmares beyond any measure. And sensual daydreams to treasure forever. Can't you just see it? Oh.
got to get out of this trap before this decadence saps our wills. I gotta be strong and try to hold on, or else my mind may well snap and my life will be lived forever.
Be with a deadly skin. You get a hit and your mind goes ping. Your heart will thump and your blood will sing. So let the party and the sounds rock on. We're gonna shake it till the life is gone. Rose in my world, keep me safe from my trouble and pain.
We're wild and a tame thing. We'll be with a deadly sting. You get a hit and your mind goes ping. Your heart will thump and your blood will sing. So let the party and the sounds rock on. We're gonna shake it till the night is gone. We'll always see my world, keep you safe from my trouble and pain.
We are wild, we are wild, we are wanting things. We'll be here with the deadly sting. Get a hit from the night of pain. Your heart will open, your blood will sing.
Sing on the party and the shine from the heart.
On the day I went away, was all I had to say. I want to come again and stay. Smile, and that will mean I may. I realize I'm going home. Out in the rain, free to try and find again. Cards for sorrow, cards for pain. 'Cause I've seen. My eyes, and I
can't go on. I'm going home. I'm going home. I'm going home. I'm going home.
Riff Raff produces his laser, capable of emitting a beam of pure antimatter, and goes to shoot Frank. Columbia dives between them, takes the hit, and dies. Frank gets it, but good. Rocky likewise. In Dr. Scott's conservative view, society has been protected by this ray gun diplomacy. Riff tells Scotty that he and our two young people should leave, as he and Magento intend to beam the entire house back to their beloved planet. Sensibly, they exit before the house takes off. The three chastened earthlings stumble out into a world where the distant dawn of a very uncertain new day threatens them with its ominous arrival.
I've done a lot. God knows I've tried to find the truth. I've even lied, but all I know is down inside I'm bleeding.
And superheroes come to feast, to taste the flesh, not yet diseased. And all I know is still the beast is
face. Some insects called the human race, lost in time and lost in space and meaning.
It's astounding, time is fleeting. Madness, what takes its toll? Listen closely.